You're considered in the industry as one of the most innovative cinema operators in Switzerland, probably across Europe. What is so unique about Arena and how do you differentiate?
At some point, I was thinking, how do I bring young people back to the cinema? Away from streaming, away from mobile phones and so on. And that's when I looked around the world. What are the technologies that offer something more than just watching movies? And then I first came across 4DX, moving chairs, atmosphere with rain, wind and so on, accompanying the movie. And then the next innovation push was the cinema with three screens, where you have the movie all around when you're sitting in the auditorium. Then I tried out how it would look when there isn't a projector anymore, and that's when Samsung stepped in with a screen that was ideal for me. And that was the Onyx LED wall, as they call it today. And that's what we implemented. And now we have a technology from Andy Boli, Immaculix, for the future, and we hope to win new customers for our cinema.
And where do you get the innovation from? Do you travel around the world? How do you come up with attractions like moving chairs or rain from the ceiling?
It is not something I came up with. I just scraped the ideas together. When I travel and find something interesting, I immediately pick that up and want to implement it here. So it's my curiosity that lets me be a little bit on top of things, nothing else.
You mentioned LED Onyx from Samsung. An LED wall is something completely different in projection. Do your guests notice a difference? Are they willing to pay extra for that? Or is it a different immersive experience?
They don't pay more. I'm charging the same ticket prices. When they enter the auditorium, they can see that it's an LED wall. When they buy the ticket, they don't know the difference. But it's a much better picture quality, and most importantly, it's a cinema experience that's new. You can enjoy the movie even with the lights on. This is very interesting for events, and I think for the movies, it's a great solution when we finally get away from this projection that always changes the image a little bit until it's finally on the screen.
With LED, you could also build and design cinema centers in a completely different way in the future, or?
Yes, we can do completely different groupings of the chairs. We can design auditoriums differently. For example, I can hang the screen on the ceiling and people lie on the floor, or I can place it on the floor and the viewers hang in ropes or whatever. I can imagine many types of setups. Unfortunately, the current formats of these screens still prevent us from doing the really crazy things. But that will change. I have already been offered a special foil that bends. That's the next step.
But then ends again with projection, or?
No, the image comes from inside the foil.
Is it like a hologram?
Not a hologram yet. There was a development before. They wanted to get rid of CDs and DVDs and then wrap the movie directly in a plastic sleeve. Then you see the film on the plastic foil. And that's the logical progression, but in large format, like from LG. That should actually come next, and then we will surprise you.
I'm looking forward to seeing that, but cinema is much more than that. A cinema center is a destination. From the business case perspective, people don't only go into the movie theater, but also the lobby hospitality area is very important. What do you offer your guests here? before, after, in between, what can you say that distinguishes the cinema center and that makes it a destination?
Ja, also gut, wir sind ich habe einen Kollegen, den Herrn Weber.
I have a colleague in Nuremberg, for example. He offers gastronomy and bowling and all kinds of things in his center. Unfortunately, we can't do that. We are limited in terms of space. We are limited to cinema and image projection. What we do is events. We also host the Zurich Film Festival here. We can also do large events like trade shows. In the end, it's limited to the cinema experience. But within that cinema visit, of course, we try to make the program as intense as possible. We have 18 screens, and of course that gives us a great variety. And it's also a pleasant place for, especially for the families, because they can leave the children in the auditoriums. It is safe here. We have a nice space in front of the cinema where the children can skate. The parents can go shopping while the kids are in the cinema. But unfortunately, we don't have culinary offer in the auditoriums.
But your cinema is integrated in a shopping center. It's not a big box somewhere out in an industrial park. It's part of the city.
Right. That's our big advantage. We have shopping here. We have hotels, bars and restaurants in the immediate neighborhood. And that makes it interesting for us, of course. And that's why we don't need to have this culinary offering ourselves. It's enough if we are up to date regarding the cinema and the movies.
In conclusion, what's your vision? What will cinema look like in 10 years, in 15 years from now?
Also, ich glaube vom Konsumverhalten.
If we look at the consumer behavior, people come here and have a cinematic experience together. That, to me, is still the case in the future. So I don't think we're building single auditoriums like video cabins in some erotic stores. You still experience and share cinema together. The emotions, the laughs, the joys, the crying and so on. That will continue to be the case. What will change a lot, of course, as you mentioned, is projection. My dream is the hologram that you sit in the middle of the picture so that you experience the cinema left and right. That would be fantastic. And I believe it will come. It's just a matter of time. And there's also the social-cultural role that a cinema plays, that we bring generations together. The grandfather can have the same experience as his granddaughter in a movie that they both like. They can have that at home on the sofa too, but there they are distracted by a lot of things. And here they can fully concentrate on the experience. So I think cinema is still a wonderful story, and it will be for a long, long time. As long as we still have the desire to communicate with each other, cinema will exist. But when we stop doing that, then cinema will be dead too.